Nandi-Ndaitwah was speaking at 71 years of India's Independence Day in the capital. In her address, Nandi-Ndaitwah paid homage to India for becoming the first country to grant full diplomatic status to the Swapo Party at the height of colonialism. She also commended the Indian government for providing diplomatic training to 22 officials from the Ministry of International Relations and Cooperation in New Delhi last year. Namibia and India, Nandi-Ndaitwah emphasized, also share keen interest with the long overdue reforms of the UN Security Council, which should allow for equitable representation in the interest of all members.
India's success in achieving sustainable economic growth and lifting millions out of poverty in a democratic post-election colonial setting is something Namibia would like to emulate. We hope that we can draw from your rich and varied experience as we continue to broaden our cooperation.
On his part, Indian High Commissioner to Namibia, Prashant Agrawal, says deepening relations with Africa remains the highest priority to build capacity on the principles of equality, mutual respect and benefits. India is also Namibia's fourth largest import partner, according to the 2019 statistics issued by the Namibia Statistics Agency.
The Indian community in Namibia may be very small, but it has made deeply meaningful contributions to Namibia. They are a very valued link between our two countries. And I'll just give you one example of Mrs. Mary Phyllis Yesudasan, the principal of St. Boniface College in Rundu, who hails from Kerala in India. She has traveled all the way from Rundu to be with us today. And under her guidance, Boniface College produces all the top students, I would say winners and champions of Namibia year after year, year after year.